Hey, welcome to Flight Test. I'm Josh.
I'm Kelly.
And this is your son, who?
Anthony.
And what did you guys make?
Over the last 5 years, me and my son in the garage have kind of crafted these box kites, and we've started adding the tails and motors, and over the last 5 years, it kind of just transformed into what you see here, which is kind of a finished flying box that flies extremely well with LEDs that you can fly at night or during the day.
If you guys remember back in the early days, Chad Capper, when Flight Test first started, had a dream of making a box fly, and we failed miserable. We had probably 8 different attempts. We actually put it out to the community, and we never got a successful box to fly. We tried all sorts of different things. And what I think is really special, you said 5 years. Didn't want to overlook that. It's not 5 weeks, not 5 days, not 5 months. 5 years you guys put into this thing, and I can understand why. It's difficult.
Yeah.
But the best thing is, you did it with your son.
Yeah.
So what was your experience like doing this?
It was fun. It was different because I've never built an airplane like this before that you just don't go out and buy and just like a kit.
You guys are creators, not consumers, huh?
Yeah.
Very cool. Now, you guys even went down to the motors. You had your motors custom made.
This is me and my son's project, but I have to add, there's a third person that went with this, and his name's Danny Snye. He runs GoBrushless.com, and he custom made these motors for us.
What was the major thing that you had to overcome? Because I know when we flew, we had one axis control, but not two.
Yeah, originally when we had these, we were doing, I think what you guys were doing, you were using the vector thrust.
Yes.
We had the motor and the servo, and we were turning this, but you know, we quickly figured out that when the motor went dead, you couldn't control it. It would just go down to the ground.
Yes.
So actually Danny said, you need to put a tail on it. So we made this fixed mount right here, and then we put the tails on there. And then once we put the tails on there, we still had problems. It would porpoise and weave and bob, but we worked on it long enough to get the right geometry with the high alpha and the battery in the right spot that the porpoising quit. And it used to, your guy's box too, I think I might say, it might have wiggled back and forth like that. We had a lot of that going on. We kind of eliminated that now.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, let's go ahead and put these in the air.
Okay.
Guys, from my heart, thank you for doing this project together and also sharing how you made it happen.
Oh, no problem.
This schooled us all.
Okay, thank you. I appreciate that, Josh.
No problem. Let's get these in the air.
Okay.
So what's the material that you use?
It's called Icarix, and it's kind of like nylon, but like half the weight.
Oh, wow.
It has a lot, it doesn't stretch and it doesn't fade. It has like a 20-year life on it.
Oh, wow.
It doesn't, you know, it has really good characteristics.
And what do you glue it together? What do you seam it with?
It's actually all sewn together.
Sewn together?
Yeah, with kite stream.
I'm amazed how much control you have over this. That's just not, it's unnatural, you know? And you said you have a 4-to-1 power ratio, huh?
Yeah. About 2 minutes, you can remove 4 of the rods and they'll fold up flat in a kite bag, about 22 inches by 22. So you can, because it'd be kind of hard to transport, you know, maybe if you're going long distances, they get crushed in the car. But like I say, we made them so they'll pack up really neat, because I travel with them a lot too. Like if I'm going anywhere, I always put one in the car or have it with me.
And right, even in this one, we probably have a good 8 to 10 mile an hour wind. Even in this wind, it's not porpoising bad at all.
Time's incredible because we're flying with about a 500 milliamp battery, but you're flying only about third throttle. So you mean you get like 15 or 20 minute flight time?
Oh my goodness.
And you just fly forever. I mean, if you were flying full flat out, you know, doing tricks, you would have a lot less. Oh, watch out. Fly out there.
That was a good angle. That is amazing. So do you have plans to manufacture this in the future?
I guess we don't. We would like to, but we just don't have. We need to hook up with the right person that's is either in the kite manufacturing or could help us like mass produce like the sail and a few key components. Maybe make like a short kit out of it.
Yeah.
So you can take all the hard work or the mystery out of someone trying to like make one of these.
Now our thing is foam board, but I'm sure someone in our community is probably saying, that's me.
Yeah. I need to hook up with a kite person that's kind of has the same vision we do, where they kind of fit the bill between flying a kite and a radio control airplane.
So friends, if anyone can help this guy bring this to reality, go to probably Fantastic Low Kite on YouTube, make a comment, maybe you can see it that way.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I can see that. Or you can even just ping you guys, you know, maybe
there
contact
you, go.
You guys might be a good one.
Let us know, we'll pass on to the channels that be. That is amazing ingenuity. I know right now Chad Capper is sitting at home saying, that's amazing! But most of all, thank you for taking on a project. 5 years in the making to make this happen.
Yeah.
But I bet you it's 5 years of memories for this guy, and I think it's really special.
Appreciate that, Josh.
Thank you. Friends, we want to thank you for watching. If you have any special pictures, go to @flighttest, #flyingfamilies. Post your pictures, especially with creating projects like this. And we'll see you next time.